Yeah, good morning and welcome to Corporate Finance Online Classes. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Onjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. So, dear students, we are learning about the second decision of the finance manager, that is the financing decisions. So, if you can recall, okay, there are three major decisions a finance manager needs to take. The one is investment decisions. Second is financing decisions. Third is dividend decisions. All three decisions the manager has to take in such a way which can maximize shareholders' wealth, because that is the ultimate goal of financial management. So, with this background, let me quickly go through what we had discussed in the previous class. Yeah, last class, I gave you a detailed recap of what we have discussed so far in Unit 5, Chapter 18, Operating, Financial, and Combined Leverage. So, where we have learned and illustrated operating leverage and degree of operating leverage, then financial leverage and a degree of financial leverage, then combined leverage and degree of combined leverage. Just remember, the degree of combined leverage measures the percentage change in earning per share due to the percentage change in sales. So this data or information is important for the investors. Okay, this is one of the criteria which is considered by investors to decide whether to invest or not in the equity shares of a company. Then, yes, we learned an important concept, EBIT, EPS analysis. Okay, so as a percentage, yeah. In the presence of the fixed cost sources of funds, in the presence of fixed cost sources of funds, given the same level of EBIT, how the earning per share changes in the different financing plans. Okay, depending on the presence of fixed cost sources of funds. That is what EBIT EPS analysis is. So, EBIT EPS analysis is used by a finance manager to decide, okay, so which financing plan to choose, or what should be the proportion of debt and equity in the total capital. And this was illustrated through this case study of the firm which already had a 10 lakh rupee capital, all consisting of 10,000 equity shares of 100 rupee each. And this firm wanted to raise additional 10 lakh rupees for expansion purpose. So the finance manager could raise the additional 10 lakh rupees in four different methods, or through four, any of the four alternative financing plans. Okay, so I hope you can recall. Only equity, so zero debt. Okay, then 50% equity and 50% debt. Okay, so debt represents the fixed cost sources of funds. Then 100% through debt or debentures, then 50% through equity and 50% through preference capital. So only in these two cases it represents the fixed cost sources of funds. Okay, but the earning per share under financial plan B was the highest, as you can see, 4.1. And though our entire 100% of additional 10 lakh rupee was raised by way of debentures in financing plan C, still its earning per share is lower than financial plan B. Okay, so that is because a judicious mix of an appropriate mix of debt and equity has to be used. Okay, and that optimum proportion of debt and equity increases earning per share, and that is how is determined through EBIT and EPS analysis. Okay, so students, any questions related to EBIT EPS analysis? One more case we'll solve. Okay, but before that,
No, sir.
yeah, thank you so much. Now, before we move on to the next EBIT EPS analysis, what we did so far is we solved a problem to illustrate the concept of operating leverage and degree of operating leverage. That was before your examinations. Then we solved a problem to illustrate the concept of financial leverage and degree of financial leverage. And then we learned the degree of combined leverage. Okay, then the next concept of EBIT EPS analysis, which we discussed through one case. Now we'll go ahead and solve some additional problems. Okay, so in today's class we are going to solve one problem where we are going to calculate the degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage. Okay, so though this data will be readily available in BSE Bombay Stock Exchange for a listed company, but being a financial management student, okay, you should be able to calculate the degree of a combined leverage or total risk of a firm, which is used as a, one of the important criteria in making a decision whether to invest or not in the equity shares of a company. So how to go ahead and calculate degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage is explained in this problem. Okay, so though it is from a textbook, but it has also appeared in one of the old question papers. So we are going to consider this problem where we are going to compute the three leverages. So according to the problem, students, I hope you can see this PDF file, right?
Sir, no, sir.
Now? Hello?
No, sir.
You can't see anything.
Then all this time you kept quiet and we did not inform you that nothing was visible. Okay. God bless you all. I'm going to share the screen now. Okay. Can you see the PDF file now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. And please tell me if you cannot see the screen. Now, in this case, I just forgot to share the screen. And I was using the PDF file and referring and then explaining about EBIT EPS analysis. Okay, remember, please. It is good if you remember and you keep alert. So we are going to solve some problems now to compute how to learn how to compute a degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage. So the following is the balance sheet of V Limited as on 31/3/2014. So you see the balance sheet, liabilities, and assets. So liabilities include equity capital, okay? And it is mentioned the price of the equity share is the 10 rupees per share. Then equity capital is 1,80,000 rupees, 10% debt. So there is a debt capital as well, and the interest on debt is 10%. The debt capital amounts to 2,40,000. Retained earnings are 60,000, and the current liabilities are 1,20,000. On the total liability side, it is 6 lakh rupees. Among the assets, net fixed assets constitute 4,50,000, and current assets constitute to the amount of 1,50,000. Total 6 lakh rupees. There is additional information here. The company's total assets turnover is 2.5 times. Asset turnover ratio. Asset turnover ratio is 2.5 times. The fixed operating costs are 2 lakh rupees. Okay. And variable operating cost ratio is 40%. See, using this, you need to calculate some data which will be used in the calculation of degree of combined leverage, financial leverage, and operating leverage. And income tax rate is 50%. So you have been asked to calculate three leverages. See, in the examination, it will be simply like this. So you should know that the three leverages are degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage. Okay, so I hope this is a typical balance sheet you might have learned in semester one, and some information, additional information provided to help us calculate the three leverages. Okay, so first we are going to prepare some working notes because we need information on sales and variable costs are directly not given. Okay, because sales and variable costs are required to calculate degree of operating leverage. Sales minus variable cost divided by EBIT. Okay, we'll give you a degree of operating leverage. So first, how do we determine sales? Okay. So what information we have is total assets. So what you can see is total assets are 6 lakh rupees, and we have some information like company's total asset turnover is 2.5 times. So if you multiply 6 lakh into 2.5, that is nothing but sales. So total assets are 6 lakh rupees into the asset turnover ratio is 2.5. We'll give you the total sales of the company, 15 lakh rupees. Okay. Then variable cost. So what information is given? Variable operating cost ratio is 40%. This is 40% of total sales. Okay, so this is general knowledge, you can say, or in accountancy, common sense. You should know this. When we say operating ratios are 40% dash dash, it means operating cost, variable costs are 40% of the total sales. Okay, so variable costs are 40% of total sales. Total sales we just determined 15 lakh rupees. So 40% of 15 lakh rupees is 6 lakh rupees are the variable cost. Okay. So any questions here, students? How I determine the sales and variable costs? Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. So you are able to understand the concept, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And we also need sales and variable cost, okay, to determine EBIT, because without EBIT, we will not be able to calculate a degree of operating leverage and financial leverage. So please remember. So using these working notes, okay, so we are going to find out the EBIT now, because EBIT is not given in the problem. So how we arrive at EBIT? See, EBIT, always remember, it is self-explanatory. Earnings before interest and taxes, that's it. Earnings before interest and taxes. So we first write the sales volume, 15 lakh rupees, from which we reduce variable cost, that is 6 lakh. So what we get is called as a contribution. Please remember, sales minus variable cost, we get contribution is 9 lakh rupees. From which you deduct fixed cost. So fixed cost are given in the problem. It is 2 lakh rupees. Okay, so you can see here. Fixed cost are 2 lakh rupees. So 9 lakh minus 2 lakh is 7 lakh rupees are the EBIT, earnings before interest and taxes. Okay. So we will need only information till here. Okay, so if you want to calculate operating profit or earnings after taxes, you can go ahead and calculate the remaining rows also. But I'll stop here because I got what I was looking for, that is EBIT. So now we have sales volume, 15 lakh rupees. We have variable cost, 6 lakh rupees, or the difference of sales minus variable cost is contribution, that is 9 lakh rupees we have. As well as I have the information on EBIT now, that is 7 lakh rupees. So let's go ahead and calculate all the three leverages. Okay, so please remember, degree of operating leverage is equal to sales minus variable cost divided by EBIT. So just now we have found out sales is 15 lakh rupees, variable cost is 6 lakh rupees. So 15 lakh minus 6 lakh is equal to 9 lakh rupees, directly I have written here, divided by EBIT. So EBIT is 7 lakh rupees. That's it. Okay, but your intelligence will be in preparing these working notes properly and estimating or computing the EBIT, or earnings before interest and taxes. The rest all is simple. So degree of operating leverage, 9 lakh divided by 7 lakh is equal to 1.28. Okay, in same way we'll go ahead with DFL, degree of financial leverage. Yeah, I think we need interest here, that's why it is calculated. So EBIT is 7 lakh, from which we deduct interest. Okay, so where interest is charged, please see. 2,40,000 rupee in the total capital is from debt source. And the debt carry 10% rate of interest. So we have to calculate the interest on 10% of 2,40,000. So students, 10% of 2,40,000 is how much? Yes. 10% of 2,40,000. Yeah, 24,000,
sir.
Yes, excellent. Thank you. So that is what we are going to use here in calculation of DFL. Degree of financial leverage is equal to EBIT divided by EBIT minus interest. So EBIT we have already determined 7 lakh rupees divided by EBIT 7 lakh minus interest is 24,000. I just orally showed you how to calculate 10% of 2,40,000. So once you simplify this, see, first you need to reduce, deduct 7 lakh minus 24,000, whatever it is, then you have to proceed further with division. So the answer will be 1.03. So degree of financial leverage in this case is 1.03. Then you can obtain degree of combined leverage simply by multiplying degree of operating leverage by degree of financial leverage, okay, which is 1.28. Okay, into 1.03. As you can see here, degree of operating leverage is 1.28 and degree of financial leverage is 1.03. Okay, so the degree of combined leverage of this firm is 1.32. The degree of combined leverage of this firm is 1.32. Okay, so you can say that the earning per share of the company, the earning per share of the company changes by, okay, if there is a 1% change, if there is a 1% change in the sales of the company, the earnings per share of the company change by 1.32% in the direction in which the sales change. Say, for example, if the sales has increased by 1%, the earning per share will increase by more than that, 1.32%. Same way, if the sales have decreased by 1%, the earning per share will decrease by more than that. That is, the earning per share will decrease by 1.32%. Okay, so this is what, how it is interpreted. So any questions here now? Okay, so before we move on to the next problem, so I hope this problem is very beautiful and simple, which will make you understand how to calculate degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage. Yes. Any questions? Starting from the data given in the problem, then to the working notes, then estimation of EBIT and calculation of interest, followed by calculating degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage. So any question, students? Any question?
No, sir.
Yeah. Please, okay, keep responding. It is good for you also. And good for me as well. So I'll take attendance now. So please make it quick. Abhijit. Abhishek.
Present, sir.
Alain.
Sir, she was present, sir.
Yes, thank you. Amrut. Anagha.
Present, sir.
Anusha Kautekar.
Present, sir.
Anusha Achari. Anushri.
Present, sir.
Ashwini. Asra.
Present, sir.
Swati.
Yes, sir.
Balappa. Bharti. Chinmayi.
Present, sir.
Deepa.
Yes, sir.
Dodda Basaya. Ganesh.
Present, sir.
Iranna.
Yes, sir.
Shrikant.
Yes, sir.
Karthik.
Sir, Karthik is present, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Lakshmikant.
Yes, sir.
Manjula.
Yes, sir.
Manjunath. Muttava.
Present, sir.
Nagamegha.
Present, sir.
Nagaraj.
Present, sir.
Nagashri.
Present, sir.
Sakshi. Pawan.
Present, sir.
Pavitra.
Present, sir.
Pooja. Pooja Ballari.
Present, sir.
Pooja Jain.
Present, sir.
Pooja Kadam. Purna. Pradnya.
Present, sir.
Praveen. Puneet. Rakesh.
Present, sir.
Ruchita. Keshav.
Sir, he said that his mic is off, sir.
Thank you. I'll mark him present. Sahana.
Yes, sir.
Sir, even Ruchita, sir.
Who? Ruchita. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Please help me, like this. Then Samiksha. Samiksha is present. Sanjana. Sankalp.
Present, sir.
Sanket Kumar. Shilpa MN. Shilpa Ganji. Shiva Kumar.
Present, sir.
Shruti.
Present, sir.
Saurabh. Surjana.
Yes, sir.
Suman.
Present, sir.
Sumok.
Yes, sir.
Sushmita.
Yes, sir.
Swati.
Present, sir.
Tabasum.
Present, sir.
Uday Kumar. Vaishnavi. Varsha.
Present, sir.
Vedesh.
Present, sir.
Nishad. Okay.
Sir, Samiksha is also present.
Thank you. I will mark.
Sir, roll number 13.
One minute. First, Samiksha. Then, next.
13, sir.
1, 3.
Yes, sir.
Bharti, okay.
And 28. Yes, sir. And even Sakshi was present. Sakshi, roll number 28.
Yeah, 28. Sakshi, correct. Thank you. Then, next, anybody else?
Sir, Ashwini is present.
Ashwini, okay.
Sir, Uday is
also. Yeah, 1 minute. Ashwini.
Yes,
first.
Sir.
Ashwini, okay. Uday, then.
Sir, Pooja Kadam.
Uday, 1 minute. Uday. Then Pooja Kadam. Pooja Kadam. Yes, anybody else? Is that okay? Yeah, I hope it's okay. So, yeah, we have come to the end of class.
39 present, sir.
39, 1 minute. 39 is Ruchita. Ruchita, you are marked present. Some of your friend informed. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so I hope, okay. So it was a good session. Simple problem, but yet it gave us deep insights. So just let me share this before we break for the day. Yes, okay. So in between you can keep logging out if you like. Okay, just let me share this and wish you a pleasant day to all of you. Okay, students, now okay. So can you see the screen now? YouTube page?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So enjoy the song. Those who don't like, you can keep logging out in between. Those who like, for 2 minutes, I'll play. That's it. Audio is audible, right? Sound is audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank
yes,
you.
Sir.
Just enjoy the song and have a beautiful day. Okay, thank you everyone. Good day to all. Have a beautiful day. Okay, see you tomorrow again.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, so I'm going to end meeting now.